Now, what is redemption? Redemption means to buy back something which was lost by the payment of a ransom. See, if something was lost, you buy it back. God made you and I. We were made in His image and in His likeness. But through sin, God lost us to the devil. We are His creation. But how can God get us back? He has to buy us back. Redemption, my friend, is not cheap. There is a price that is paid. But this price is paid simply because of love. Not because you're worthy of it, but because God can see Himself in you and God is longing for you. He is willing to pay the price, and that is called grace. You don't deserve it. You did not earn it. His love wanted to get you back. Church, I want you to know, we were gods, but we are twice gods now. Glory to God. Redemption means to buy back that which was lost by paying a ransom. The Bible, in the Bible, this word redemption occurs 9 times, always with the idea of a ransom or a price being paid. Always with the idea of a ransom. Redemption, there is no redemption without the payment of a ransom. Something has to be given in exchange. Now, when you sinned, legally man became a slave of the devil. The devil had complete and total authority, control, and ownership on man. Now, although God made him, God could not take him back. He had to pay a price. So that's why there is no redemption complete without a ransom being paid. Why did Jesus come? To give His life as a ransom. He paid a price for you and I with His life. Redemption is not just a theological term. It is something where an exchange took place. A price was paid that God could own you again. It is through redemption that you could become a son of God. Many people of God have suffered for the kingdom. Right? Many people died on the cross along after Jesus. Many were burnt at the stake. But none of those were for the redemption of man. Every suffering that Jesus suffered, the blood that He shed, the life He gave up, the death on the cross was for a purpose, was just for you and I. The suffering of Christ, the death of Christ, the death on the cross of Christ can never be compared to anybody else's suffering, because this suffering of Jesus was a ransom, a price that He was paying that you and I may be redeemed. Somebody say amen. Amen. So don't ever compare anybody's suffering with the suffering of Christ. The idea is that of a payment being made for redemption. Remember, there is a debt that we owe, a debt of sin. But the debt against us is not viewed as simply canceled. Our debt of sin was not just canceled, it was paid for. There is a difference between a debt being canceled and a debt being paid. When we are declared righteous by God, it's not because our sin has been canceled, but whatever the price is, it was paid. Say amen. So remember, somebody had to pay. That's why salvation is free, but salvation is not cheap. It costed the life of the very Son of God. Christ's blood or life, which is surrendered, was surrendered as a ransom, by which 2 things happened. 1, deliverance from slavery to sin. 2, not having to pay the penal consequences. Therefore, friend, our redemption is by the blood of Jesus. It is this blood of our Lord that makes us worthy to become partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. See, we were not worthy for it, but by the blood of Jesus, we are now qualified as worthy to become partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. It is by the blood that it took us out from under the dominion and the domain of the devil and has brought us unto himself. Watch this. It is by the blood. Somebody shout, it is by the blood. It is by the blood you are delivered from what? From the power of darkness. That means the powers of darkness have lost their authority over you. And he has translated us into the kingdom of his dear son. Glory be to God. There's something extremely significant that happens when a person is born again. You are removed from a kingdom. There are two kingdoms. Kingdom of darkness and kingdom of light. And the Lord Jesus said to that rich man, there is a big gulf between these two. You cannot go from here to there. Amen? You can't. But the blood is the bridge. Glory to God. The blood is the bridge. The blood of Jesus delivers you from the dominion, from the domain, from the authority, and from the power of the devil. And now he translates us and brings us into the kingdom of his dear son, our Lord Jesus Christ. What I'm giving you this morning, my friends, must become a reality in your spirit, man. You got to grasp this in the spirit. Because every time the devil will come, now remember, the devil is a liar, he's a cheater, he's an imposter. He will try to convince you that he still has authority over you. He will try to convince you that he still has power over you. So he'll come and try to harm you. And you cannot sit back and say, well, I don't know. It feels like I'm losing. No, you don't lose. You say, devil, what right do you have over my life? Take your dirty hands off me, because God has given me the power to cast the devil out. In my name, said Jesus, you shall cast the devil out. Glory to God. So you have now got power, because you're no longer under the rule and the authority of the devil, but you're under the rule and authority of Christ. And Christ has given you the right and the authority and the power to bind the devil and cast him out in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout amen. Amen. So you're no longer a helpless creature. You're no longer a helpless religious person. You are a child of God, bought with blood. If there is one thing the devil fears, it's the blood of Jesus. If there is one thing the devil does not have an answer for, it is the blood. It can replicate and pervert many things that we do in the kingdom. But one thing it does not have an answer for is the blood. When the blood is presented, the devil has to withdraw. You are redeemed by the blood. Glory be to God. You're not a loser, you're a winner. That's why I told you, the blood is a weapon of victory. Whenever you present the blood, the devil has to retreat. Glory to God. So don't just sit there and say, I don't know why I'm suffering like this. I don't know why God is doing this to me. I don't know why God is a loving. Hey, listen, God is saying, I've given you the element. I've given you the weapon. I want you to start using it. I want you to start the weapons I've given you. And one of the weapons that God has given us is the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. We got to learn to use the blood. Hey, listen, church, look up. You know what the blood has done? It is by the blood we've been raised with Christ. I know you were born only a few years ago. 30, 40, 50, not more than that. Christ was raised 2,000 years ago. But when was he really raised? Before the foundations of the earth were laid. Come on now, amen? And in the eye of God, when Christ was raised, he saw you being raised with him. Glory. So now he says, when Jesus rose from the dead, you rose with him. And now the Bible says Jesus is seated on the right-hand side of God, right? What is the right-hand side? The right-hand side is the seat of authority and power. The right hand of the throne of God represents the seat of power and authority. So he says, you are now seated with Christ in heavenly places. Glory. When he is seated in heavenly places, you and I are seated with him. And you know what he declared? All authority and power has been given unto me. Now, if it's been given to him and you are seated in him, where is the power and the authority? Come on now, say it. Say it. Say it like you mean it. In me, glory to God. Because he has given it to you, and it's all by the blood. Glory. So whatever is under the authority of Christ is under your authority. By this placement, all things under his authority automatically come under your authority. Hallelujah. See, when we lack, now you can sit there and say, this is the dichotomy, this is the problem. We're listening to it, but our experience is saying it doesn't match with it. And if you believe your experience, you will never experience what God has said. But if you will believe what he said, your experience will line up with what he said. I hope you understood what I said. If you believe your present experience, you'll wonder whether what I'm teaching is the right, is the truth. But if you will believe the truth and you will act and receive it, your experiences will begin to change and line up with what God's word says. Listen, the blood, my friend, therefore, is the guarantee for your access to the throne of God. Now the Bible says, by the blood of who? Not bulls, not goats, not sheep, but by the blood of Jesus, you can enter the holiest of holies. How? Not with fear, but by boldness. Somebody shout boldness. That means I know I have a guaranteed access into the holiest of holies. God is not going to strike me dead, because when I walk into his presence, I'm covered by the blood. I'm covered by the blood. That's why when you go to God in prayer, plead the blood. Plead the blood. The blood is what cleanses you from all sin. The blood is what cleanses it. Cover yourself with the blood. Because when you come into the presence of God with the blood of Jesus, my God, God the Father says, you're welcome. You're welcome. Because that blood cleanses you from all sin and all unrighteousness. What I'm showing you is, through redemption, God has once again crowned his prime creation as the king of the universe. Glory to God. That's why he calls us what? Kings and priests. You're not just a forgotten, beaten down, losing, good for nothing religious person. No. Through the process of redemption, by the power in the blood of Jesus, you who were once lost have now been bought back with that blood, and God has positioned you in a place of authority and dominion. Somebody shout amen. Amen. Redemption has bought you authority. Redemption has brought you into a place of dominion. Redemption has given you the access, the guaranteed access into the very throne room of God. Redemption has translated you from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of his dear son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Redemption has given us inheritance in the Lord. Somebody shout amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So next time you hear the word redemption, don't think it's a theological term. Redemption is required for your crowning. You cannot be crowned a king. You cannot be called the son of God without redemption. But don't ever forget, redemption is not cheap. Jesus paid it with his life and with his blood. That's why our lives are always indebted to the Lord Jesus Christ. Without him, we were lost. But with him, we are found. And we are now called kings and priests. Somebody say amen.
Thank you for joining our online community. For weekly updates, make sure you subscribe to our channel and also click the bell button for further notifications.